So you've read The Name of the Wind, you've read The Wise Man's Fear, maybe you've even read some of Rothfuss's shorter works, even reread all of these things multiple times. And with no foreseeable release date for the third book,
you're left unsatisfied. Dead inside.
Well, that's why I'm here, to give you some book recommendations to help scratch that itch. To make the wait for the third book, The Doors of Stone, a little bit more bearable. So what is the Kingkiller Chronicle known for? It's known for its lyricism, its beautiful prose, it mainly focuses on one protagonist. It also has a school setting and a fascinating magic system. Now, none of the books that I'm gonna recommend have that exact same feel or tone of this series, but each of them share something that makes me think that people who like the Kingkiller Chronicle are going to enjoy these ones as well. And hey, maybe one of these will be your new favorite. But first, a quick word from today's sponsor. Are you tired of using Goodreads? Do you want an easy way to meet new people and chat about books? Because it's kinda difficult to do that in person these days, for obvious reasons. Well, let me introduce you to ByZans, a new app where you can discuss your favorite books with other readers in various different chat rooms. If you mark a book as currently reading, you can discuss with people who are also currently reading that book. If you mark a book as read, you can talk spoilers allowed with people who have also read that book in a separate chat room.
It's the best of both worlds.
Obviously, many of us are spending a lot more time indoors, so I think an app like this is perfect for connecting with more readers. You can share your profile with friends and follow them, and did I mention that the app is completely free and it's also ad-free? That's right, no advertisements. I can't even say that about my videos. I gotta eat somehow. So why don't you come chat with me? Make sure to check out the link in the description to download ByZans. If you're looking for another cunning and manipulative main character, then I'd go with The Lies of Locke Lamora by Scott Lynch. One of my favorites that I hardly ever talk about.
You don't deserve this.
This series actually has a third book. Like Foeth, Locke is an orphan who's sort of a jack of all trades. He learns the art of acting at a young age when he's adopted into the Gentlemen Bastards, a group of elite con artists robbing the rich of everything they're worth. Locke is full of wit and charisma, which he often uses to get out of tough situations. Anyway, if you haven't read it yet, you should. I mentioned the Earthsea books by Ursula K. Le Guin in my recent spring recommendations video, and I talked about how it was an inspiration for the Kingkiller Chronicle. Le Guin even wrote a blurb for The Name of the Wind. So if you like the Kingkiller Chronicle, then you owe it to yourself to read these books. The influence that Earthsea has had on fantasy is extremely underappreciated. Now, these books also follow an arrogant child destined for greatness who goes to a magical school and has a rivalry with a fellow student who's rich and pompous. Oh, and the magic revolves around knowing the true names of things. Sound familiar? Rothfuss may have used the same formula, but both books are very much their own, and Earthsea is well worth your time. Assassin's Apprentice by Robin Hobb, another favorite of mine I should probably talk about more. Robin Hobb is incredible at making flawed and realistic characters and their relationships that just happen to be in a fantasy setting. Her writing and her characters are always amazing, though if you are more of a plot reader, it can be a bit slow at times. And don't go into this series expecting some Assassin's Creed action or something similar to Brent Weeks' Night Angel trilogy, because you won't find that here. Assassin in the context of these books is more so about someone who solves political problems discreetly while using murder only as a very last resort. Which I think actually feels pretty realistic, though I can see how the title of the books might lead some readers to expect more assassinating than this series actually provides. But what it does provide is the life and times of Fitzchivalry Farseer, a character you're gonna feel bad for because he goes through a lot. Now, in a similar way to Kingkiller, these books start with the protagonist telling his story all the way from childhood. It's got a very interesting magic system, and both the Farseer books and Kingkiller have a certain sadness to them that I kind of love. Why not throw a manga in there? Fullmetal Alchemist is filled with a lot of mysteries and secrets that are revealed, and the story has loads of lore related to alchemy, storytelling, and the politics of the three main countries. Not to mention, it comments on the realities of how victors define the history books and the heroes, which, depending on which theories you believe, could also be a big theme in the Kingkiller Chronicle. Tigana by Guy Gavriel K. If you saw my first Bookshop Adventures video, you'll know that I recently found this one at a used bookstore. Now, I can only comment on it briefly since I've only read a few chapters, but as far as prose goes, and just the overall effort that went into the writing, I can tell that it's a book that could appeal to the Kingkiller fans. It definitely appeals to me so far. A Song of Ice and Fire by George R.R. Martin, for those of you that really want to read another unfinished series. The Dragonbone Chair by Tad Williams. The only reason this kind of reminds me of the Kingkiller Chronicle is that Tad Williams has beautiful prose. It's also one of my favorites. I'm gonna be saying that about a lot of books. Tad Williams basically took the classic fantasy quest that was so prevalent in the 70s and 80s and refined it to the best that it could be. This is definitely an old-school 80s fantasy masterpiece, and so it's not exactly comparable to Kingkiller, which uses a very modern, conversational tone to convey very traditional fantasy. They're both very different, but I think fans of either could find something to like. The Dragonbone Chair focuses on world-building and character development to the point where the plot is almost secondary. The descriptions are very beautiful and detailed, bringing the world of Austin Ard to life. But one thing that I do want to point out is that the beginning of this book is very, very slow. It takes over 100 pages or so until it finally picks up. But once it does, I would definitely say it's worth it. So those are my recommendations. If you've got some to add, if you're a big fan of the series, and you've read some books that kind of remind you of the Kingkiller Chronicle, then make sure to let me know down in the comments. Also, if you like the videos that I make and you want to help support the channel, then make sure to check out my Patreon. I want to give a special shout out to my most recent Knights Radiant tier patron, Amber Pfaff. Amber Pfaff. Amber Pfaff. I am so sorry. I don't know how to pronounce names.